Good morning, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me once again. I had some great questions about Old Faithful, Yellowstone, super volcano, and I want to address some of those questions today. The live camera for Old Faithful is still down. Here we have a screenshot from 12:59 yesterday, March 11th. Today is March 12th, 2022. Sunday, tomorrow, is daylight savings time, so don't forget to turn your clocks ahead tonight when you go to bed. Yellowstone has had quite a few earthquakes. 15 in the last 24 hours, the largest being a magnitude 3.8. But it was actually a 4.0. Six people said they felt this earthquake. Over there by Cadwell, Boise, Idaho, there was two responses from there. Using Google Earth, here's the location of that. It was actually a 4.0. It was about 5 miles deep, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. And here you can see we got a fault line drawn out, and then I got a fault line drawn out in green, and I've talked about this. This is the Trans-Chalice Fault System that runs all the way up to Canada. We don't think about Canada when it comes to an eruption of Yellowstone. One of those in our community, and you know who you are, thank you very much for sending in your question, asked about Alberta, Canada. According to cbc.ca, you guys would not be safe from the fallout of the ash, either on the ground or in the atmosphere, if there was another major eruption there at Yellowstone. An area covering southern Alberta to southern Manitoba would probably get up to 1 meter of ash, which is over 3 feet, actually about 39 inches of ash. For those of you that may be new followers, you may not be familiar with all the different reports that I have done about Yellowstone. Here we have Alberta. Can you imagine 3 feet of ash? Here we have Edmonton. So let's go to Manitoba. That is way over here. Way, way, way over here. Right there. Manitoba. Here we have Lake Superior, Lake Michigan, Hudson Bay. So I kind of drew it out in a blue line. 3 feet of ash. This would shut down transportation, collapse buildings, short out the electrical grid, and cause massive agricultural failure. Ash would diminish with distance, but Toronto would see anywhere from 1 to 10 millimeters of ash according to the same models. Airborne ash would ground most air traffic and cause respiratory problems. More disturbing, debris in the atmosphere could reduce the Earth's surface temperature by several degrees Celsius or more. This would result in a global cooling event that could last for many years or possibly decades upon the eruption. Yeah, we're talking about a mini ice age. So let's go to Toronto. Right there. Yellowstone has had about 40 smaller eruptions since its last major eruption. They don't really talk about that. And I'm going to bring this out so you can see. Toronto there and Yellowstone way over here. The black lines that I have drawn out for those that are new in our community, that is the distance that the ground has risen as of 2015. Some of Yellowstone's smaller eruptions, more recent eruptions, was at the Craters of the Moon Monument. The Native Americans talk about this eruption. It was probably less than 10,000 years ago. This is an eruption of rhyolite. And I've talked about rhyolite. Rhyolite is one of the magmas that has the most gases in it. Kind of like shaking up a can of soda, popping the lid, and kaboom. Yeah, one of the most highly explosive magmas that you could possibly have. And this area is rhyolite. Not too long ago, one of the roads going up to Mammoth Hot Springs got so hot because of the heat from the volcano coming up under the ground. It actually melted the road. Just recently, when they were surveying for roads up in this area, they found cinder cones, other signs of past eruptions that they did not even know existed until they surveyed for the road. So there's been probably more than 40 eruptions since the last major eruption. And like I said, they don't talk about these smaller eruptions. Bob Smith of USGS there in Utah believes that the next eruption, or that at least they're hoping the next eruption, will be a small one. And a small one, according to them, would be something in the size of what Mount St. Helens did. Here I downloaded three different monitors. This here is Moose Creek, Idaho, Holmes Hill, and this is a borehole. It's a very deep well under the ground, about 500 to 600 feet under the ground. It's in the Madison River area. And this here is a spectrogram for what they're claiming is a 3.8, but it was actually probably a 4.0. All the earthquake signatures marked in red is what the computer picked up and then sent a message, a text message more likely, to the geologist notifying them that there was an earthquake. So I'm going to play this for you. This is from yesterday. There was a couple times where the steam coming up from Old Faithful looked a little dirty. Now, when it's dirty, that means the material, the dirt, the rock, under Old Faithful heated up to the point where, it was melting the rock, and so it came up with the steam. And you can see the time here. And this is, in fact, from yesterday. Currently, the only people that can get into Old Faithful and the Yellowstone is either snow coach or by snowmobile. But that's going to shut down on the 15th because they're going to start doing road maintenance, clearing the roads of the snow to get ready for the reopening of Yellowstone National Park. Yeah, look at all the people. I'll bring it down a little bit. And I'll give you a link to this. See how dirty that is there? Yeah, it got a little dirty. Yeah, lots of people coming into the park, and you can see the different eruptions. Some were large, some were small. And this is at almost 2 o'clock p.m. Mountain Time. Here we have another eruption that was at 2:36 p.m. And we'll bring it forward a little bit to see what was going on with Old Faithful. And last year, the year before, they were talking about how the ground here at Old Faithful had risen by, I can't remember if it was a couple inches or a couple feet. I don't remember. Now, there's another eruption, almost 4 o'clock. It's supposed to erupt about once every 90 minutes. And we'll bring it over. Go forward a little bit. See if we have another eruption. Yeah, my Ring doorbell notifies me when there's activity outside my door. And I'm in an apartment building, so there's lots of activity. It looks like Yellowstone, Old Faithful, geyser has not been going off as often as what it's supposed to do. If you want to go to other dates, all you have to do is change the year, the month, and the day. So we got the month 03, the day the 11th. It won't show what's going on today until tomorrow. It won't post. And then you change the date. Let me try and get part of this lit up for you. So the 22 is the year, 03 is the month, and this here is the date. But you also have to change the month right there, and you have to change the year right there. You can look at past archives. I'm not sure how far back they go, but you can look at other static camera images, and it'll show you. Pasting them all together. So at 2:36 and then again at 3:58 it erupted. Yeah, it's not erupting every 90 minutes. And then the one before that was at 12:59. Here we have it at 12:58. 11:21. That one looks like it was a small eruption. Okay, 11:20. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I could be wrong in estimating the time. Like I said, it's supposed to go off every 90 minutes and don't look like it's doing that all the time. But like I said, I could be wrong. They had three earthquakes yesterday or today within the last 24 hours. These three are by Heart Lake. I got this one picked out. The magnitude 1.5, 8.2 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 5 miles below sea level. Once again, all earthquakes are measured from sea level. There's its signature at Moose Creek, Idaho. Let me bring this up. Holmes Hill. And this is from the borehole. Again, at Madison River. Here's a document I want to show you I have saved on my computer for the different boreholes. Right there is borehole 207. These again are very deep wells, and I'll bring it down so you can see the document. This is for Madison River. It's got a top covering of cement, and it is 687 feet deep. The monitors for the earthquakes are 636 feet. I'm going to make that bigger for you. I'll make it bigger yet for those of you that might be viewing it on your phones. And we'll bring it over. Can you see that? Make it a little bit bigger. All right, and we'll bring it over. All right, so here's the seismic signature. And I come up with a magnitude 2.62, not a 1.5. And we'll look at the spectrogram. Let's see, let's bring this over. I shortened it up because there's another small earthquake afterwards right there. At 6:54 in about 25 seconds, there's another small earthquake. It's not marked in red. It's small. They're not reporting that. I want to look at the signature. Yeah, volcanic harmonic tremors. All right, we got this one. I haven't done that one. At 17:49, that would have been yesterday, universal time. They put everything on here, universal time. Up by Hedgen Lake, they're saying it's a 0.8. But in fact, it's a magnitude 1.81. And we'll go to the spectrogram. And I really shortened up the signature. See how I ended it before the signature even was finished? Yeah. Again, this comes from a borehole 207. which is 661 feet for the monitor for the seismic waves. They do this so that it doesn't get any interference from any outside noise. No traffic, no snowmobile, no stampeding buffalo, anything like that. So that's that one right there. We got more marked in red. And we got another one. Looks like several earthquakes. We'll go to the signature. Yeah, we got one there. Long P wave on it. Sometimes it goes small on me, though. I have to close it up and reopen it. And then we got another one marked in red over here. Let me pull it over for you. Right there at 557. And that's all I pulled. It looks like we got a thickening of the lines right here. Let me make this big, this a little bit bigger. This is Holmes Hill. And we'll extract that. Yeah, we got volcanic and harmonic tremors. For those of you that may be new following me, this is a signature that magma is on the move coming up in the system. You know, until Mount St. Helens erupted, they did not even know about harmonic tremors. This one here looks like tectonic. And the reason I say that is because it's got sharper tops to it. All right, let's come down here to this one here. See how they're more rounded? Those would be volcanic. Volcanic and harmonic are basically the same. See how they're more rounded? So that's all I have for you right now. Yeah, the 15th, you won't be able to see the people coming in because they're going to have the roads closed for snowmobiles and snow coaches. Keep sending those questions in. If you have any more questions, please put them down below. I do read over all the questions that I do see there on YouTube. Sometimes they don't post them for me to see. I don't know why. But I do look over all the comments that you put. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all.